Analytics with Nux. This is a new set of videos where I'm going to share the checklist that people should follow before doing certain tasks. So say for example, in this case, 5 things to consider before starting Power BI report. So I'm going to share some checklist that people should follow before starting reports, right? And it can be like a performance improvement. What are the things you need to consider to improve the performance of your report? So this is the structure of this playlist, and it's named as Nux Checklist. Let us try to begin today's video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So what things you need to consider before starting Power BI report? So first and foremost thing is to know your source data, right? What is your source, where it is existing, whether it is in database or Excel or SharePoint. You need to understand more about it, right? And how frequently the data is getting updated in the source and what is the volume of it. So these things you need to understand very crucially, so that you can design your proper extraction phase. Then understanding about report readiness or refresh frequency. This is something like always in Power BI reporting, you can see like people wants the report immediately, or it can be people wants to, once the source data is updated, they want to see the report in the Power BI or not, right? So this is a crucial question. If you are in an import mode, you cannot able to achieve it, but if it is in direct and live connections, you can able to do it, right? Even in live connection, you have certain kind of delay, right? In where you have to bring the source into SSIS cube, from there you can read it. So this kind of things you need to ask in the initial stage itself. Because why I'm put this point is like, once you design your report in an import mode, you cannot roll back to the direct query mode. So just ask the users how they want, how quickly they want to see the data. Then comes Power BI report requirements versus capabilities. So the users may be thinking about Power BI, like they have seen some visuals in the internet or some other tools, and they want to implement same thing in Power BI. So you need to understand the clear requirement from the client or the user, whoever requests for the report. So if it is not doable in Power BI, you need to say upfront it is not doable, right? So just get what are the kinds of different visuals that people expecting. If the requirement is already defined, they need these kind of charts, then you need to say that. But there will be sometimes like user doesn't aware of anything about Power BI, just they will give the data, then they will ask you to design your report. In this case, this is not so important. But if there is specific requirements, and just cross verify once and then confirm it. The number of users or who is your report user also plays very crucial here. Like if you design your report and how many users they want to access that particular report and who are there to edit it, right? So you when you are designing a report for the department, and there will be 1,000 people in that department, whether all users are going to use it or very few people are going to use it, right? So based on that, you can able to decide on whether the row level security is required or not. So these kind of questions you need to ask in the initial stage, so that your designing phase will be very simpler. I have seen some cases like once you design everything properly in import mode, then implementing row level security becomes complex, right? It is not able to do it in many to many. You need to redesign it again. So when you ask in the initial stage itself, whether RLS is required and number of users going to access, based on that, you can think of what kind of solution fits to this report, right? So that is one of the another important checklist. Then last but not least, design or sketch the modeling. So people, once they receive the data, they just start extracting the data into Power BI and then generating the report. That is very quick, as we are aware, most of them, like once you get the data, you can create the report. But this applicable to a very small or very straightforward reports. But when the report requires some complex logics, it involves 5 to 10 tables and having different granularities, please do design or sketch your model, how your star schema should look like. You need to design it properly in some tools, Visio or some other sketching tools. If it is not available, just try to draw it in a piece of paper. That is more than enough before directly implementing in Power BI. I hope I'm clear about what things you need to start before starting your Power BI project. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset. And one last thing, if you think like something has to be added in this checklist, just comment below and we will add it. Or some people who are seeing the comments, they will also get benefited from it. Thank you so much.